Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? Why, I'm feeling pretty on top of things. Thanks for asking. Why is it I'm feeling on top of things, you may well ask? Well, that's because I use Boomerang for Gmail. While it works on other email clients, it works best in Gmail, I think. What is Boomerang for Gmail, you may well ask? Well, I say to you, that is a lot of questions. But fortunately, you've come to a person with a lot of answers. If you stick around, I will show you Boomerang for Gmail. I am so glad that you're going to spend some time with me today looking at Boomerang. Boomerang is probably my favorite single Gmail add-on. It's, I think, the most useful tool that you can add to Gmail. Now, I say Gmail, but Boomerang works in other email clients. You can download it for Outlook, but it's really a superstar in the Gmail world. Let me show you why I think it is. What Boomerang does is it helps us overcome email overload, but at the same time, it gives us tremendous control over all of our communications that are happening in Gmail. So all you do to install it is it's free to install. There is a premium plan that you can pay for an upgrade to, which is very reasonably priced per month, but you get access to pretty much all of the tools in the free plan so you can see if you like it. So you just click and install Boomerang, and it basically installs as a browser extension. And then when we're working with we're working with Gmail, we have access to it. And I can see it right here in the very top of my menu bar here is Boomerang. And if I click on that, I can go in and I can manage all the settings, et cetera. And they've got little bonuses, like if you refer friends and you have people sign up, they've got that kind of social growth idea where you get free months of the premium service and your friends get free months. So they've got all that kind of nice stuff happening. And I do think, if you do become a Boomerang convert, that you will be referring lots of friends, because it's just one of the programs that people get. When they use it, they go, how did I ever live without it? So let me show you what I think is the kind of, in order of preference, the top features within Boomerang, the things that make the biggest difference. And for me, the single biggest feature that I use all the time in Boomerang is the ability to take an email that's in my inbox that I'm not ready to deal with, and be able to remove it from my inbox, but then return it when I am ready to deal with it. Let me show you. Let's imagine that this email is from somebody that's important. It's actually from me, but it says, I got a whole bunch of things for you to do, Steve. Oh, geez, great. I got a whole bunch of things for me to do. Okay, I'm not ready to do these things because I've got to wait for feedback from my third me before I'm ready to do this. So instead of dealing with this right now or leaving it in my inbox, what I can do is I can actually click here and I can ask it to Boomerang to me. See, if I click on Boomerang this to me in 2 days. So I can say when it's going to come, and then I can ask it, I can just send it out. And what will happen is it just basically removes it from our inbox and it just kind of goes out there onto the internet. I'm not sure where it lives. It goes on a little vacation, I guess. But in 2 days, it comes back into my inbox as a fresh message. And theoretically, at that point there, I am ready to deal with it. Isn't that an awesome way to deal with it? That's why they call it Boomerang, is you're not ready to deal with something now. You're waiting for feedback from somebody else. But if it's sitting in your inbox, what happens is psychologically it weighs on you because it's there. You open it and you wonder, oh, it's just having a whole bunch of things in your inbox reminding you of how much work is coming up is not really conducive to Zen in your life. Having it out there and returning when it's ready, fly free, butterfly, come back. Oh, that is conducive to Zen, I would say. The second most popular feature is delegation, as far as I'm concerned. If I have an email come to me and it's something that I think somebody else should be dealing with, I have no hesitation whatsoever to take that email and instead of reply, to forward that email. Well, if I'm going to forward that email to somebody, I would like to know if they indeed deal with what I'm asking them to do. So I can use the Boomerang features again and I can say Boomerang this back if the person has not opened, if they've not replied, or if they've not clicked on the email. So this makes me a responsible delegator. If I've asked you to do something, it's still sort of my responsibility to make sure it gets done. So if you haven't replied to me on or at least open this email within 2 days, then it returns back to my inbox, and then I know that I still have to reach out to you again or deal with it myself. So I think this is a great management tool, not necessarily email management, just overall project management and team management tool, by knowing when other members of your team are doing things which you ask them to do. So that's part two of Boomerang. And you know what? It's worth installing for either one of those two features, but there is more. You might have noticed when I talked about this that I said, if they've opened it, well, that means that they've actually built in email opening tracking. They've got tracking built in to Boomerang, and they can track whether or not an email is opened, and they could also track whether or not an email links within an email have been clicked on. And you enable that right here by clicking on this little button here. And that adds a little line within each email, which enables the tracking, but it also informs the person that they are being tracked. See, some people have a little bit of an issue about tracking. They consider that it might be a bit of an invasion of privacy. Well, I don't know whether it is or it's not. But the bottom line is the folks at Boomerang think that we should have an option to opt out of being tracked should we choose. So as soon as you enable tracking in any message, they include this little message here within it saying you're being tracked. And if you don't want to be tracked, if you don't want an email being sent back to the sender, which lets them know that you've opened this email, then click here. And then you're probably thinking, well, that does a lot of good. I've opened the email. They already know. No, there's a buffer period. It's about 10 minutes that Boomerang gives the person that's reading the email to discover the fact that they're being tracked and then to respond and be able to disable the tracking. So that's a fair, kind of a fair contract on both sides. Now, if you leave tracking on, this is what will happen back at the ranch, as it were. So I sent an email out to myself a little bit, to one of my other accounts a little bit earlier with tracking on, opened it. About 10 minutes later, I got this message back, which just says basically that my tracked message was opened by me when. So about 10, 15 minutes after an email is opened at the other end of the internet pipe, you will get a message back into your inbox telling you that the person has opened the email message. Now, one word of note. If you're reaching out to somebody, asking them to do something, I wouldn't, the moment that a message came in saying that they've opened it, be on the phone asking them if they've done things, because that's probably a good way to get them to turn off tracking every time you send it to them. Deal with it responsibly, but it does give you a better handle on what's happening as far as the engagement with all of your communications going out. The last thing that I'm going to talk about is something which is surprisingly useful when you stop and really think about it. And that is, again, let's just go reply here and I'll show you one other feature. This one here called Send Later. If I click on that, that opens up a little dialog box that allows me to choose to send this reply or this fresh email at a later time. And I can choose, there's a whole bunch of presets here, 1 hour, 2 hours, based on when we are. Or if we click on the gear icon, indeed, I can actually go in and I can make some custom times for sending different emails. Now, so you can use this as a reminder being sent to you to remind you to do something. Some people use it very creatively like that. But for the most part, here's the use case. Friday afternoon, you're banging through a bunch of emails. Now, if you send them off to the people that you're sending them off to Friday afternoon, chances are they've already left the office for the day and you're going to be the bottom email in a whole stack of email that they're going to receive over the weekend. You're probably going to have a lower open rate of your email and you might not get noticed. However, you can say, you know what, send this Monday morning at 9:45. So you've done all of your work Friday. Now it's out of mind. It's not in your inbox anymore. It's not on your to-do list, but it's not going to be sent to the person or arrive in their inbox until the time you designate, which is going to dramatically increase the likelihood of them opening the email. That is a great use case. Personally, I also use it for this use case. I often can't sleep at night, come in here and do a little bit of work at 2 a.m. I don't necessarily want the people I'm corresponding with realizing that I am that obsessed with work that I'm firing off emails to them at 2 a.m. And a lot of people don't actually getting emails at 2 a.m. Sometimes they have their phone by their bed and it's buzzing when there's email coming in. Now, I personally leave my phone outside of the bedroom, but you might be doing that and then they might read it at 2 a.m. And all of a sudden you're engaged in a dialogue. You're embarrassed, they're embarrassed, but now nobody can sleep. This way, if I'm doing stuff at 2 a.m, I say send it tomorrow morning at 7, send it at 7:30, send it at 8:00 a.m, and then they don't know that I've been working on it all night, but they're still getting it at the top of the morning when they're able to deal with it. And it's basically, I've again been responsible, got my work done, got it off my plate. It's arriving at a time when it's more likely to be dealt with. So those are the main features. Boomerang does a few other things, but if for those basic features alone, it is, I think, well worth considering. You just drop by boomeranggmail.com. You can install it. As I say, there is also an Outlook version that you can install within Outlook. But if you are a Gmail user, you have to try this app. There's just no option. I think you should try it. I hope you found this to be valuable today. If you have, there's three ways that you can become a part of our little community here on Dotto Tech. First, I encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just click on the link there and subscribe, and then you will know about all of our new videos as soon as they're released. In a similar vein, sign up for our newsletter. I send a digest out each week, which contains all of the different emails or all of the different videos that I create that week, as well notification of all of our live events and webinars. And we do a fair number of really interesting and creative webinars that you might want to participate in. So please sign up for our newsletter and you will get notification of all of those. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We use a very cool service called Patreon, which is like Kickstarter, but for content creators like us, and it allows me to spend my time concentrating on content instead of going out and getting sponsors for the channel. And my community says we'll give a little bit of money each month to help support you, Steve, in creating this content. So for as little as $1 a month, which works out to somewhere around 5 cents per video, you can become one of my Patreon patrons, which makes my day, I can tell you, every time somebody signs up. So check out the Patreon page, take a look and see if it's something that you might consider engaging in. And with that, I have to thank you so much for spending time with me today. I think if you try out Boomerang for Gmail, you'll feel that this little bit of time you spent with me today was time well spent. I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.